Remy Zero with Life in Rain, my Sheward soundtrack this week, used in the Smallville series and especially for Dawn Juxon. Thank you.
That's very nice, very chilled and relaxed.
It really was. In fact, after listening to that now, I'm a bit like, oh, I could just lie back, chill out, relax, chillax.
Oh, I don't
say.
Like chillax. It annoys me.
I know.
But otherwise, you don't say grangry if you're grumpy and angry.
Oh, grangry. But we could try.
Or ankpy. No, I can't do the other
one. No, we're like grumpy.
Grumpy?
Yeah.
No, grangry.
Grangry.
Grumpy's a grandfather.
Oh, yeah. I'm really grangry. No. What is it? Grangry.
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 It's like gangrene.
Oh, no.
But it's good, actually. It's a good end of the week. Cause, of course, it's been a four-day week.
Yes, Monday. Which has been fabulous. Nice. Did you do relaxed. Much on your Monday?
No, weather wasn't great, was it?
No, it
didn't
wasn't,
do a lot.
To be fair.
Spent most of the day with my girlfriend, which is nice.
Aww.
And, yeah, I must congratulate her, actually. She's in a show at the moment. Performing at Welsh College Music and Drama.
Oh, congratulations, Laura.
Yeah, on tonight and yesterday, and it's really good.
Oh.
Very, very good.
Oh, so we can't even promote people to go and see it.
Well, it was a very limited audience anyway.
Right.
So there's no point, and it was, yeah, it wasn't worth promoting it because it's all sold out basically.
Oh.
But that's good. It went well. So there we go.
Hey.
Happy times.
Welcome. On the weekend I saw my parents last weekend.
Oh, yes, how are they?
They came to visit me with the dog.
Oh, so that's not a nice way to talk about your mother, but...
Ooh, cheeky.
Sorry, Mrs. Sheward.
It was actually really good because they came down and the dog jumped out of the car. I shouted his name and he just ran and leapt at me. And he's this little King Charles Cavalier. And it was almost just like this big ball of happiness.
Oh.
Just leapt onto me and just filled me with absolute joy. So it was brilliant to see my parents last weekend. Oh. So I had a really good bank holiday weekend.
Well, that's lovely. And you weren't grangry at all?
I wasn't grangry.
Not a hint of grangry.
Well... No.
No. Good.
Always happy. Positive, pouting Peter.
Oh, God. It's
a lot of alliteration. A little bit of alliteration. Maybe I'll need some more P's to go in front of it.
Painfully
positive, pouting Peter.
Yes. Poetic.
Oh, I like that.
You like poetic?
Yeah, I just can't spell, though.
No.
I really can't.
I know, bless you.
I'm so glad that we have spell checker on things.
You'd be flummoxed without it.
I would. Back in the olden days when there was no dyslexia and no... No, there wasn't. There wasn't a word for it. You were just
Yeah, there is
thick.
Still dyslexia.
Yeah, but people were just called thick.
Yes.
You're stupid.
Well, yes.
You're thick.
Yes.
You're dumb.
Yes.
There was no ADHD, was there? You were just a horrible little terror that ran around and had far too much energy.
Some would say, some still are.
Oh.
But I wouldn't.
You know, before they realised that tartrazine in your orange juice made you hyperactive, you were just a naughty little brat that needed a...
Tartrazine?
You know, tartrazine.
What's tartrazine? Doesn't that go on top of, like, Christmas cakes?
Or no, is it in... that's marzipan.
Oh, right.
Two different things.
Sorry, I got confused.
Tartrazine, this is one of the only things I ever learnt from food technology at school.
Right.
One of the only things. It's an additive that they put in orange squash. And what it did, it would make children hyper. So any kind of orange-flavoured products that, you know, like orange lollipops, orange chews, it was kind of put into that. But it would make children really, really hyper. And so they tried to take it away from all those products.
Wow.
So there you go. Welcome to Tartrazine Knowledge Corner.
Yeah. You learn everything on this show, don't you? Here we are, relaxed on a Friday night, just getting ready for the nice weekend, learning about tartrazine and marzipan and grangry. All the words. You can just, like, learn a new word every week with this show.
Well, I think we should. Maybe that's a new feature we could do. Come with a new word, like cytogeneticist, philanthropist.
Whoa! Cytogeneticist? What the hell is that? Right, okay. So some sort of somebody who works with genetics on site.
Well, no, I believe. No, I could be wrong.
Oh, here we go.
I'm getting all cocky.
It's
but
a monkey
believe...
on a bike with a head mask.
It's not a white noise.
What's a head mask?
A head mask. It's a mask that you wear on your head.
Yeah, apparently so. Go on.
No, cytogeneticist, I believe, has something to do with plants and the reproduction and the genetics towards plants and other living things.
This is a very advanced link for us, Pete.
I'm sounding like I'm on Radio 4.
Welcome to Carry On Friday here on Radio 4. We've been learning about cytogeneticism and whether you get grangry or not. Send us your opinions about the human body.
Actually, I don't want to diss Radio 4.
Right.
Because we respect other radio stations for giving what they give.
Yeah.
And I was actually listening to them talking about the ever expanding universe and cosmos. And I was really interested in that. Couldn't repeat it back on air because... it didn't really sink in that much. But it was quite interesting to think that it is expanding and then around the little areas of nothing and all time, space, reality.
Do you know what, Pete? I think we've gone too far. Yes. This is not caring for
it. Back.
Yeah, can you talk about how hot men are or something?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Do you know who's really hot at the moment?
Go on then, quickly.
Mark Foster, who apparently I missed swimming in Cardiff some lengths for some sort of charity event.
Oh.
And I could have gone and seen him and gone, hello, Mark, because he bats for my team, apparently.
No, he doesn't. Isn't he swimming on your side of the fence?
swimming on my side. What are they things called that separate lanes? Yeah, swimming in my lane.
Swimming in your lane.
Yeah, along with Colin Johnson.
Who?
Colin Jackson.
Oh, Colin Jackson. Is he? Now, that could be slanderous. He's a Welsh legend.
Yeah, he's also...
So definite, is it?
Well...
Is he out?
I don't know.
Well...
If I've outed Colin Jackson, I do apologise. If he's already out,
great.
That's great.
If he's not gay at all,
then I,
even better.
Yeah,
not even better. Yeah,
maybe, but any whatever he is, we're all
bail out, Pete. Bail out. Bail out. Okay.
Give me a hard hat for the whole of digging. Give me a hard hat.
Yeah. Coming up, we've got some gay glaziers. And is it Ciara? Sierra?
Sierra.
Sierra.
Yes. Yeah. Not Cortina.
But before that,
and we gay glaziers and a Cortina. Sorry.
Shush you. Before that, we've got a Coldplay song, but it's a B-side. It's a B-side from Clocks.
Right.
Clocks.
Yes.
And it's called Crests of Waves. So enjoy.